All right, so what we're going to look at now, even though we probably filmed half an hour of this already, the mic wasn't on. All right, it's okay. Is we're going to now look at our control positions in Jujitsu. I tell everybody, right, Jujitsu isn't that complicated. And in my mind's eye, there's probably two core positions in Jujitsu. There's control and guard. Okay, so what guard is very simple, we've already talked about it. Anytime my partner's knee line, okay, not legs, knee line, is in between me and his core, his body, okay, that is guard. So right now I'm in guard, right now I'm in guard. The second this happens, I'm not in guard. Okay, now I'm working for my control positions. In control positions, being anytime you have access to your partner's hips and shoulders inside that like gooey center, they control positions when the legs or the knee line isn't in your way. Okay, so that's quite a simple way to really conceptualize what Jujitsu is there. For anyone new starting off, you know, what are you supposed to do? Well, you want to be in a control dominant position on your partner. You do not want to be in between their legs. Okay, so to start off with our control position, side control, and we're going to start using a model to help you problem solve and really understand conceptually what's going on. Okay, so when I look at Nick, Nick's quite a beautiful man, but I don't look at Nick's natural beauty when I see him, right? What I see on Nick is I see his head, I see his shoulders, I see his sternum, and I see his hips. So head, shoulders, sternum, hips. Okay, much like your Iron Man, right? With that chest piece right there. And in terms of that, why that's important is because in order for me to control Nick, I need to have two things. I need to have points of control on my partner, three as a minimum, and then I need correct and effective weight displacement on my partner. So we're just going to recap really quick why weight displacement is important, because the application of leverage is really the summarization of what Jujitsu is. So that basically means if I'm applying no weight to Nick, Nick can move effectively, he can do what he wants, right? He can go to the shops, he can never come back, whatever. I start applying a little bit more weight to Nick, while Nick moves around, it becomes a little bit harder for Nick to move. Okay? I apply a lot more weight to Nick, it becomes harder and harder for him to move, right? So what you're gonna figure out is, this is Jujitsu basically defined, it is the effective sort of transmission of leverage from you to your partner. That's basically what it is. He's trying to, if he's on the bottom, trying to frame to accept my weight so he can move, create space, and do what he wants with his hips. And if I'm on top, I'm trying to apply maximum effective and efficient weight to him so I can do what I want to him and he can't move. So, head, shoulders, sternum, hips. They're the points of control that I want to interact with on my partner. The first position you'll probably learn in terms of side control is short-based side control. So in this situation, I'm going to be touching his hips, his shoulder, his head, and his far shoulder. So I've got 4 points of control, and my weight will be displaced through his chest. So this is short-based side control right now. My right knee is on his hip, yeah? My right knee is next to his ear, my right hand is under his head, and I have an underhook right here. My chest is on his chest, okay? To really finish this position off, what you'll sort of think about is, well, when I roll with that black belt or that brown belt or that high-level guy, he feels way heavier than 80 kilos or whatever. Well, in terms of weight displacement, it's physics, right? We're building wedges and we're building that angle in which I'm applying weight to my partner. So an exercise to start practicing in terms of applying weight to your partner is you have your chest directly on top of your partner. Now, I feel about as heavy as, you know, I'm fine. But I'm not obscenely heavy here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to slide my sternum back and I'm going to lean through my partner. I'm not putting much extra effort in here, I've just changed the angle in which I'm interacting with my partner's chest with my chest. Okay? And all of a sudden, I feel much heavier than I did before. Now, it's important in this position not to drive through your partner. People that over push and over drive, what's going to happen is that point of contact with your partner will be shifted. And if you shift it further and further up, that's when you're likely to get swept, because the point of contact with your partner is over his centerline, and where your weight is displaced is over his centerline. What you're trying to sort of achieve when you apply weight to your partner is when you hit that angle, you're trying to make sure it still comes into that center point. So instead of pushing your partner, try and think about this as a lean on your partner here. So you're sinking back, and then you're leaning through your partner right here. Okay? I've still got my major points of control here. I have my knee next to his ear, I've got my cross face, I have my underhook, and I've got my right knee next to his hip, and then I have my good weight displacement. This is a nice top control position.